considered to be the pendant among the 38 jewels in the chain of national laboratories of the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research in India, IICT and its coal and gas technology division have been focused on the development of cleaner processes for utilization of the low-grade Indian coals since very inception. Initiated in the mid-60s, the 24 tons per day coal gasification pilot plant project, it concluded in the early 90s, earned international acclaim when it obtained UNDP assistance to the tune of $1.2 million during the period between 1980 and 85. In the backdrop of the oil crunch created by the Arab oil embargo in 1973, the coal gasification project at IICT was given thrust area status by the then Prime Minister Mrs. Indira Gandhi. Accordingly, large multidisciplinary teams were built to carry out the specialist job on hand. The erection of the plant equipment done departmentally was completed and the plant could be successfully commissioned by 1983. UNDP, through its report, applauded the quality of work done by the Indian engineers and suggested to the government that the facility be maintained as a global coal testing facility. The crushed coal was carried to the vibrating screen by a conveyor belt and the feed coal fraction of 6 to 25 mm in size was lifted onto the bunkers using an electrical hoist. Feed coal was charged into the gasifier operating under pressures of up to 24 bar through a coal lock vessel, and the fine powdery ash that formed as a residue during the process was discharged through an ash lock vessel at the bottom. Demineralized water was used as feed to a stoker fed boiler that burns the slag coal to generate 2.5 tons per hour of high pressure steam at 33 bar and 400 degrees centigrade, which was used as a gasifying medium along with the pure oxygen that was cryogenically separated in a cold box of a 250 normal meter cube per hour air separation plant. The input gaseous reactants were controlled from the control panel. The 1500 normal meter cube per hour of crude gas exiting the gasifier was cooled downstream to separate the condensates in two stages and then cleaned off the acid gases such as carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide and carbonyl sulfide in a hot potash wash unit and analyzed online by a quadrupole mass spectrometer before it is burned to extinction through a flare stack. The liquid hydrocarbon byproducts such as tar and oil were separated from the condensate streams by a battery of gravity separators, and the phenolic gas liquor containing around 5000 ppm of phenols was treated to below 20 ppm levels in a biological oxidation unit for discharging the clear liquor effluent out. Coal reactivity studies to estimate the kinetic parameters in a high pressure thermogravimetric apparatus helped validation of the one dimensional homogeneous mathematical model that was developed. While special studies conducted on the residence time distribution of flow elements down the reactor conclusively proved the plug flow nature of the flow of solids in an operating moving bed gasifier, the quenching studies unraveled the manifestation of different reaction zones along the length of the reactor and helped an indirect estimation of the axial profiles of temperature and various components in the fuel bed. The pilot plant logged more than 4,600 hours of operation, gasifying more than 2,900 tons of different coals from across the country. Six different Indian coals and a lignite sample from Neyveli were tested for their gasification characteristics in about 21 test campaigns. Finally, the process data collected during the testing of high ash coal from North Karanpura in Bihar was used in the preparation of a techno-economic feasibility report for a conceptual 600 megawatt integrated gasification combined cycle power generation plant as early as in 1992.